Hi guys, this video is powered by Unilab Virtual. I do hope you're going to enjoy it and derive more value from it. Kindly like, share, subscribe, comment for more videos. Thank you. Today, we are going to be looking at how to ace your experiment reporting in 10 minutes. Now, let's dive into it. The outline is in two parts. The first part contains title page, abstract, table of contents. The other part contains the chapters, which are introduction, literature review, methodology, description of apparatus, results, discussion of results, conclusion, and references. To write a title page, you need to include the title of your experiment, your name, your course title, instructor's name, and perhaps the names of your group members and submission date. Ensure it is formatted according to the specific guidelines provided by your instructor or department. Here's an example of a title page. You can see here we have the title of the experiment. We decided to choose series parallel pump characteristics experiment for this tutorial. And then the course title, PTG425. Petroleum and Gas Engineering Laboratory 3. Now you see you have your name and then the names of the group members. And then you have instructor, date performed, and date submitted. The next section is the abstract. Now, do not write the abstract first. Your abstract should be written at the end of the entire report. Then you will place it here to enable your reader or examiner to decide if your report is worth reading. To write the abstract, you need to summarize the key objectives, methods, results, and conclusions of your experiment in a concise paragraph. Like I said, one paragraph. Make it clear, informative, recommended word limit, typically between 150 to 250 words. The next section is the table of contents. You can see the table of contents here is very similar to the outline of this tutorial. The only thing is that it is more detailed. You can see the table of contents. You list all the sessions, the main session and the subsession with corresponding page numbers. Then you need to update it after completing the sections to maintain accuracy. Apart from the table of contents, which is Roman figure 3 here, you can add as Roman figure 4, the list of tables, Roman figure 5, the list of figures, Roman figure 6, list of symbols or nomenclature, and then 7, list of abbreviations. These are some of the things that you use in your report. If you have tables, figures, symbols, and abbreviations, it's good that you collect the list and then add them to be a table of content. And then after this page, you now spell it out each list so that you can have a good presentation. Now, after that, we'll go into the main session, which are the chapters. In this reporting, we can see we have about 7 chapters. The first chapter being introduction. Let us see how our introduction would look like for this type of experiment. Thank you. Now, introduction. To write your introduction, you need to state clearly the purpose of your experiments. Provide background information, highlighting the relevance and significance of the experiment. Just like we have here, we try to add the background information on pump in series and parallel experiment. And then we provide the relevance and the significance for this. And then we end with what? You end with a clear statement of objective. So you can see here the objective of this experiment. Let me move to bullet 4. The objective of this experiment is to investigate the performance of pumps in series and parallel to plot the characteristics curve, including the head flow rate curve for both setup. Now, after writing your introduction, the next section or chapter is the theory of experiment. Concisely explain the theoretical background of your experiment. You can add mathematical equations or relations explaining the theory behind your experiment. Also, you have the literature review. In the literature review section of your chapter two, you need to summarize. Review is on pump characteristics and configuration. So we have 2.5 as feature review, 2.5.1 pump characteristics. We looked at some studies such as Smith et al. 2022 highlights the significance of pump performance curves in evaluating and predicting pump behavior under different operating conditions. Then we move ahead to look at other people's work, like work of Brown and White, emphasize the critical role of net positive suction air in preventing cavitation. Cavitation is a phenomenon that can significantly affect pump efficiency and lifespan. So we see understanding NPSH requirements is essential for avoiding operational issues. So you can see how the literature review was planned out. And during your literature review, you identify gaps and controversies that your experiment aims to address. So I end the literature review with, in conclusion, a comprehensive understanding of pump characteristics and configuration is crucial for efficient and reliable operation of fluid transport systems. The next section is the methodology. Here we have centrifugal pumps, fluid measuring devices, valves and piping for series and parallel configurations, pressure measurement devices. Because this unit is compact, we just drill the configuration, the schematics of the unit. But rather, if you have some setup, they are not compact like this, like glassware, mass balance, and all that. You can draw each of the apparatus in the setup in your description of apparatus. Next is precaution. In the precaution section, you need to highlight any safety measures taken and also discuss potential sources of error and how they are mitigated. Like here, one of the precautions says it was ensured the pumps were properly primed with water. And the last precaution here says it was ensured that safety guidelines were followed when working with electrical equipment and water. Then we'll move to the procedure. To write your procedure, you need to detail the steps during the experiments, use clear sequential instructions, and write in passive voice, just like we have in this section. We have series and parallel configuration procedure, which is reported in passive voice. The first procedure on the series configuration states the pumps were set up in series by connecting the discharge of the first pump to the suction of the second pump. After this section is results. You need to present your findings using tables, graphs, and or charts. Just like we have here, the titles to the table should be on tops, and then the titles to the figures should be at the bottoms. When you are doing your experiment, you'll be able to measure the volume and then estimate the discharge, which is volume over flow time. You have to include units of measurement and ensure clarity. Refer to each figure or table in the text and provide interpretations, calculations, and data analysis. Calculate the volumetric flow rate for each configuration. Plot pump characteristics curve, including the air flow rate for series and parallel configurations. Analyze curves to understand pump behavior in different setups. Now, if your experiment is not series and parallel pump setups, you have to analyze your data according to the experiment requirements. Chapter 5 is discussion of results. Here, you analyze your results in the context of the objectives. Discuss patterns, trends, and any unexpected outcomes. Compare your findings with existing literature. You have to use prose writing style in this section. That is, you write continuously. You may have paragraphs, you may have, but no use of bullets or numbering. The next section is conclusion. Here, you summarize the key findings, state whether the objectives are met, discuss the implication and potential future research. The next section is references. You need to cite all sources used in your literature review and throughout the reports. Ensure citations follow the required citation style. We have several citation styles that are very popular. We have APA, we have MLA, we have Vancouver, and a number of them. APA 7th edition referencing style, known as author date edition, or known as author year style, is recommended for lab reporting. You can see the sample we have here. This is APA 7th edition referencing style. Generally, you need to maintain a formal and concise writing style, proofread for clarity, grammar, and spelling. Follow any additional guidelines provided by your instructor. Remember, a well-organized and clear report emphasizes understanding of your experiments. Happy writing. Thank you. This tutorial episode is brought to you by NewLab Virtual. If you have any questions, comments, feel free to drop them in the comment section below, and let's engage before the next video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe for more videos. See you.